Welcome back, everyone. We're gonna finish up Nyctalanth. Last time we were here, we completed all of the outer houses, and we got a quest from Hajin Ra. To give her the boat map. Which we will not be giving her. Spells. Have you obtained the map of the boat from the six spears? Yes. S good. Will you give it to me? No. The garrison of Tirang seem unduly agitated, as if poised to strike. Still, they part to allow you passage to the west door. No, they didn't, because I refused to give it up. All right. Nuke blast. I'm just gonna see if I can't get ahead of all this stuff. The elders are what scare me. Let's see if I can't silence you. Three out of five. Okay. I'm fast enough, I got ahead of them all. Probably could have got away level threes as well. Okay, so let's do Nuke Blast level 3. Maybe I could have gotten away with level 2 for everything. Inside the chamber, several Terangs are chopping chunks of a gutted giant bug into a sickening gruel, dumping the contents into a huge bowl. The stench is almost overwhelming. As you enter, they turn to meet the challenge.
Bye.
A finger rod. I'll give it to Minerva. You descend into a large cavern, cold and dry. The ground shows traces of the brown icky goo that seem to follow in the wake of passing Terang, an indication that they probably frequent the area. Neatly situated side by side as if statues in a garden, three savant guardians stand motionless, frozen in time. There is no indication of wounds or damage, and yet they appear lifeless and quite dead. You approach one of the immobile savant guardians. It appears to be dead. I think I use the mystery ray here. Pointing the handheld device at the frozen guard, you pull the small tong on its underbelly, bathing the statue in a wide glowing ray. Nothing seems to be happening. When suddenly, sparks begin shooting out of its head, and it springs to life in a mad berserkin rage. Savant Berserkers. I'll just take him down. You approach one of the immobile savant guardians that appears to be dead. Misfist, system failure, bzzz, crackle, bzzz, warning, overload, bzzz, 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 host, central security access, bzzz, room, bzzz, linkage server, 018@67C1, bzzz, termination sequence initiated, bzzz. And with that, the guardian charges in a fury of flames and sparks. Thank you. Trying to recall the meaningless jumble of the insane savant, you write what you can remember onto a piece of parchment, sensing that it might hold some vital clue. Who got the parchment? Did you get it? Yep, that's it. Okay. Comlink device, okay. Ring of Stars. Hugo, why don't you hold on to that? You approach one of the immobile savant guardians. It appears to be dead. So now we have two pieces of parchment with server access codes. And we'll use them next time we go to New City. Several large capped vats are stored in the corner of the cavern. Standing at the vats, you notice a dried gray crust has formed around their lips. Pry open a vat. Prying open a vat, you immediately succumb to the horrible wafting aroma of fermenting bug juice, stock for the pukey T-Rang gruel. You to cure lesser condition. Okay. Pump it up. So that's all of the high chamber for now. Now let's go to the breeding pits. Where was the way in? There we go. Livestock breeding ground. A large reinforced steel door has been installed to prevent any accidental intrusion by unauthorized personnel. Mounted to the latch of the door is a thick metal block in which a finger hole has been bored. You push the transparent rod into the latch hole. Stepping into the area, you know immediately that this building was not intended as a habitat for holding animals, as traces of faded and cracking paint covering the walls suggest some kind of artistic decoration that is not customary for slaughterhouses. Apparently, the Terang have little appreciation for such things, if indeed they have any capacity at all to even recognize the concept of such things as beauty or art. For them, a building is a place to put things, nothing more. As for this former church, once created to offer amelioration, now it is a battlefield of bloody stains. Prison, an inevitable abattoir. Stepping into the small cathedral, you are attacked by swarms of jittery bugs. Well, that swarms all right. Come on, you gonna die yet? There we go, they're starting to die. And even if I had to fight these guys just with physical attacks, it's not that hard of a battle. Just a long one. This may seem long, but it's faster than doing it the other way. It now occurs to you that some Terang is probably going to have to explain to his superiors how the food supply suddenly died. They are probably not going to be too pleased about it either. The small alcove is empty, though a faint image is still visible upon the wall in front of you. It depicts a group of rather short, squattish men kneeling before a bright radiance in the sky, in which a giant figure seems to be handing them some kind of sacred scroll. From out of the wall, a strangely familiar apparition appears. Follow me! One way trip. Just go forward. Stepping through the wall, you are not sure whether it was the stone that was momentarily turned evanescent, or whether it was yourselves. However, the slight tingling sensation that you felt as you passed through this has now receded, and the walls are once again quite solid to the touch. The yard is damp and gloomy, having a distinct aroma about it. It is then that you realize just what this weed-ridden garden really is, and what all the engraved slabs sticking up from the soddy ground represent. I'm pretty sure this just contains a long stem spade. Within the chest, you find a long stem spade like polearm, an old set of oily leather gloves, and a small bottle of spirits. Well, given that, it's definitely a set amount what you get. Cure gauntlets. Bottle of Old Jake's. And actually, I decided that I'm gonna have you carry around this. Thank you. Alright. Is there anything else that you can hang on to? In Rutus Pure, Lord Tabur. Alright, so I'm pretty sure we can use the long stem spade on anything here. Digging up the grave, you unearth an old rotted coffin containing naught but rotted flesh and bone. In Rutus Pure, und Afga. Yamiu is the one that I want, but I'm just going to go ahead and dig them all up. Yamiu, there we go. This is kind of a hidden boss. Digging up the grave, you unearth an old rotted coffin containing a rather well-preserved corpse of some bizarre creature. Uh-oh. The bones begin to rattle. To Hildur, the MEU's paw goes to Ghost. Alright, so if you did not have a Rod of Sprouts, the MEU's paw is where it's at. However, I do have a Rod of Sprouts. A Rod of Sprites, sorry. But I'm going to take MEU's paw into the next game. So that's why I'm just giving it to Ghost now. Let me update my documentation. Yes. Okay. Spanning between the two pillars, an energy field pulsates with a low crackling hum. Feeling a bit like warm steel, it serves as a barrier blocking any passage beyond it. We can't go there yet. Alright, my buffs have worn off. I guess it's time to rest a little bit. Plus, I also got scared there. Okay. The ground is somewhat soggy here, and the entire area seems to be sagging into the earth. Okay, so this one is okay to enter, if I recall. Nothing happens. At least not yet. This one, however, do not enter. Let me show you what happens. Inside the small crypt, upon an altar of stone, rests an ornate staff, sequined with jeweled. Suddenly you hear a screaming cry. Charging through the wall at a rampage, a mad laughing ghost bellows a ghastly chuckle as he grabs the jeweled rod on the altar, disappearing out the other side. And there's no way to get it back. So don't go in there. Terra Fermi. This is the one we've been looking for. We're going to cast Levitate. With who? Let's cast it with Ghost. And then we're going to use the Longstem Spade. Digging up the grave, the mushy ground beneath you collapses.
Oh.
You land with a hard thud, tumbling along the ground. Shaking the dizziness from your head, you stand up to find yourself in a large cavern. The atmosphere seems breathable, though dry and a bit stale. Peering up towards the surface, you spot the place from whence you fell about 30 feet above your head, a hole of light in the darkness of the cavern sky. Cave Thraxes, giant insects, and cave Thraxes. Okay.
Thank you.
Stepping into the area, your foot suddenly plunges into a soft spot on the ground, releasing an ochre-green grass. Gas. I'm just gonna let myself get poisoned. Gas pocket. Gas pocket. A chest. Let's see what's in it. Oh. Let me see if I get the same thing next time. I didn't have this in my notes, so it's probably not worth anything. Yep. Nothing really to get concerned over. Heavy heal? Sure, I'll take those. Gas pockets. Other than the poison gas, this really isn't that hard of a dungeon. The hard part is the way out. pick on Eagle. Okay. Alright, that's a good time to call this video. Join me next time whenever we finish the Nyctalanth dungeon and, well, the whole area actually. Thanks for watching.